The Joyce Center on the campus of Notre Dame is sold out, and for fans of the Fighting Irish, they're hoping tonight is the night their team can jumpstart their season with a win over one of the best teams in the country. Rivalry Week, presented by Cisco Systems, continues as the fourth-ranked Pittsburgh Panthers take on Notre Dame. The Panthers come in at 7-1 in the Big East. They're tied with Connecticut for first place. The Irish, 4-4 in conference. 48th meeting all-time between Pitt and Notre Dame. Notre Dame has had the upper hand lately, particularly here in South Bend, where the Pittsburgh seniors have never won. Tonight, their last chance. Hello, everybody, and welcome. Sean McDonough along with Len Elmore. Delighted to have you with us. A very important game for both teams. Pittsburgh trying to remain in first place in the Big East Conference. And as Notre Dame coach Mike Bray said, his team needs some big wins just to get on the NCAA tournament bubble.
Well, they're going to get their chance. Upcoming on their schedule, they've got UConn twice, Syracuse, Providence, ranked teams. It all begins here, though, with Pittsburgh. And when you talk about Pittsburgh, this is a team that's exceeded expectations. They do it because of their chemistry. They genuinely like each other. And this is a team that really relies on defense, the sacrifice, the help that comes with that defense. They've got a terrific inside presence as well. So the combination has really been something that Jamie Dixon couldn't have dreamed about.
And Notre Dame needing wins or the lights will go out on their season as far as the NCAA tournament is concerned. Great opportunity here, Len. The schedule gets tougher for them. Starting tonight, 5 out of their next 6 games are against teams ranked in the top 25. But that's also a great opportunity. You win a few of those, now you have some quality wins on your resume.
Yeah, Mike Bray, a lot of people criticize him for building this tough schedule and recognizing again that it would probably hurt their chances. But because they stumbled early, this is going to be the redemption for them if they can win some of those games.
And tonight we'll get a look at two of the very best point guards in the nation, Carl Krauser of Pittsburgh and Chris Thomas of Notre Dame.
But when you talk about Carl Krauser, he brings consistent scoring ability at the point, a great distributor as well as playing strong D on the ball. And Chris Thomas, tremendously gifted but struggling offensively, averaging only 9 points in the last 3 games. Mike Bray has decided to push Thomas to the shooting guard spot, allow him to get into the offensive flow, take away the point guard responsibilities, and maybe get him off the mark.
While Thomas has been struggling lately, Chris Quinn, his backcourt mate, has not. Over the last 13 games, Quinn averaging 16 points per game and shooting 49%. And he's coming off a career-high tying 25 Wednesday night in their loss at Boston College. He went 9 of 18 in that ball game. Over the last 3, averaging just under 20 points per game against Miami, Rutgers, and Boston College. Notre Dame in the home white. Chris Taft, the talented freshman, will jump center for the Panthers against Taryn Francis. John Cal to throw the ball in the air. He's working with Tony Green and Will Bush, and we're underway. And the tip controlled by Francis.
Well, you can expect Notre Dame to try to play up tempo against Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh likes to play in the 60s. Notre Dame wants to be able to move bodies. They don't believe from a 94-foot standpoint that Pittsburgh can stay with them. And they've had some luck in this building, 5-0 over the last 5. So,
and a charge called against Jordan Cornett as he went down the middle of the lane and committed the first foul of the game. Cornett, a junior from Cincinnati. Now Krauser matched up to start the game, the man-to-man by Thomas. Julius Page, Taft, and now Siobhan Troutman.
And you can see Pittsburgh exhibiting the patience, the deliberate style that they want to play. They feel, again, good execution is more important than just running the floor.
Taft over Francis, too strong off the glass. The rebound down to Cornett. And here's Chris Quinn, a sophomore from Dublin, Ohio, in the Columbus area.
Pittsburgh characterized by strong man-to-man. Got Krauser on Chris Thomas right now. That's one of the things that they do, get their hands on the ball. They don't gamble a lot, but they force you in positions where sometimes you give it to them.
Helped by the fact that Francis just did not have very good hands trying to handle that pass. Krauser missed a corner jumper, and Cornett another rebound. No score. We're a minute and 20 seconds in.
And that's going to be another key. Notre Dame has to hold their own on the boards. We talked about the inside presence Pittsburgh has now with young Chris Taft.
On 3 that rattles in for Thomas. Generally, they go as he goes, and he had 29 in the first meeting with Pittsburgh this season on January 12th at the Peterson Center in Pittsburgh. He was 11 of 22 from the floor. The Irish lost that game by 3 points.
When we talked to Mike Bray yesterday, you know, he said that he thinks his team has a feeling about Pittsburgh that they can win and really come in here playing confidently against a team, again, that plays the toughest defense in the Big East.
They have that track record of success, particularly here against the Panthers. Julius Page scored the first bucket of the night for Pitt. Out of bounds to Notre Dame with 20 seconds to shoot. Chris Quinn, part of Mike Bray's starting lineup, with Thomas in the backcourt, Cornette, Torian Jones, and Terrin Francis. They rely heavily on Quinn, Thomas, and Francis for their scoring. Not a lot of scoring depth, and that's been a problem all season long for Notre Dame.
Yeah, I was going to say, almost to a fault, they rely on those three guys. That's why Torian Jones, particularly, is so important in the offense.
Francis got his own rebound and scored. He's trying to bounce back. He had a season-low 6 points in their loss at Boston College. On Wednesday night, Mike Bray credited Yuka Agbay, the fifth-year senior for BC, for doing a great defensive job in that game on Francis. Julius Page into the corner. Krauser open for three. And the rebound, Francis. He averages 9.5 rebounds per game. Thomas, NBA, and then some. Three.
Well, I'll tell you what, the Pittsburgh defense, Sean, is breaking down. The one guy you don't want to leave open, despite his struggles of late, is Chris Thomas. And that's twice now he's gotten wide open looks.
Great start for the Irish, who have lost two in a row and five of their last seven. Troutman inside to Jerron Brown. He missed it. Out of bounds. Last touch by Francis. And the starting lineup for Pittsburgh: Troutman, Taft, Page, Krauser, and Brown. A familiar fivesome on this veteran Pittsburgh team that's had the best record in the nation the last three seasons. Brown shot blocked by Jones. It came back to Brown. Taft the fadeaway, contested by Francis, who rebounded the miss. On the run, Thomas. Quinn is open. Francis, the offensive rebound, then fouled on the floor. Fouled by Jerron Brown. And the crowd on its feet early, saluting the Irish. This team needs a lift and needs some victories, and the fans are trying to do their part tonight.
Well, so far, Notre Dame's been able to impose their will. They're running the floor, getting looks in transition. Pittsburgh not really able to cover the shooters, and again, out of the half, the out-of-bounds play, still not able to get close enough for Chris Thomas.
And a timeout. Chris Thomas, another three. When we asked Jamie Dixon, the Pittsburgh coach, why the Irish have had success lately against Pitt, he said generally because Thomas has played well. When he makes shots, they're tough to beat, and he's making shots so far.
Well, again, Chris Thomas comes off a series of screens to get open. No one steps out to help Julius Page as Page trails him, and that's just the wrong thing to do.
Well, he shot very well in that ball game at Pittsburgh, and he's off to a terrific start tonight. Matter of fact, he's almost matched his point total up in their last game. He had just 11 Wednesday at Boston College on 3 of 18 from the floor. And Mike Bray, disappointed with the loss, he said, but if we got anything from Thomas and Francis in that ball game, Thomas had 6, Francis, Thomas had 11, Francis had 6, we would have won that game against a good Boston College team on its court.
Well, I think the strategy of flipping Chris Thomas, making him the shooting guard, taking the ball out of his hands until he gets in a position to score, has certainly worked thus far.
Troutman almost traveled again. This time he got called for. Timeout, 15:46. Left in the first half. The Irish off to a great start, and we check in with Carl Ravitch.
All right, Sean, thank you very much. Iowa, Indiana went not one, but two overtimes. And it was Iowa on the road after this bucket goes in, preventing Indiana from scoring. 84-82, Steve Alford's team with a good win.
Big Monday, presented by Bud Light, every week on ESPN. Introducing the Bowflex Ultimate.
quite possibly the best home fitness machine ever made. Bowflex is so effective that we guarantee you'll get the results you want in 6 weeks or less. Own the new Bowflex Ultimate with no money down and monthly payments lower than many health club dues. Call and ask for a free video or DVD or visit us on the web today. The new Bowflex for ultimate results.
Pushing myself to the limit is what this is all about. And I need an antiperspirant that can keep up. That's why I use High Endurance Clear Gel. Try it. If you don't like it, Old Spice will buy you a stick of something else. A clear gel that strong? I'm there. Old Spice High Endurance Clear Gel.
The crying, it's a good thing?
It's a very good thing.
A Valentine's Day gift from Kay means two things. Every diamond is hand-selected, and she'll absolutely love it.
You're still crying.
I'm still happy.
Every kiss begins with Kay.
I got you something.
Oh, you shouldn't have. Oh, this is nice. And here's yours. I know it's not fancy, but it's what's inside that counts. And what's inside is Labatt Blue.
Wow. Huh? I love it.
Break out the blue. Labatt Blue.
Awesome gift.
Oh, yeah.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Rivalry Week is presented by Cisco Systems. This is the power of the network now. And in part by Labatt Blue, imported from Canada. Look up Sea Blue.
And welcome back to the campus of Notre Dame. The Fighting Irish with 8 unanswered points to take an 11-2 lead over fourth-ranked Pittsburgh. We'll be right here in the Joyce Center for Big Monday, presented by Bud Light, as the Irish host fifth-ranked Connecticut, 7 Eastern time, and at 9 Eastern, the 17th-ranked Kansas Jayhawks take on Oklahoma State. Kansas State, the Kansas and Oklahoma State is also available on ESPN HD. And we mentioned this key stretch of games, 5 out of 6, including tonight's game for Notre Dame against ranked opponents. Doesn't get any easier from Pittsburgh to Connecticut.
Well, this year Notre Dame is 0-4 versus ranked teams, and that's not where you want to be when you're 10-8. From this game on, it's put up a shut-up time for the Irish.
Jordan Cornett, the corner jumper. He's starting to pick up his scoring. Double figures in 2 of the last 3. Those are 2 of his 3 double-figure games all year. And 2 of the 4 in his career. He's a junior. Troutman got stuck in traffic.
Right now, Notre Dame turning the tables on Pittsburgh. They're the ones playing the sticky D. Not an open look for Pittsburgh yet.
And a hand check, a little too sticky from Chris Quinn.
Mike Gray working the officials, but he's got to be pleased again, and these guys are putting forth the effort on the defensive end. Last 2 games, they've given up almost 79 points. And when you only score 72, the math doesn't work for you.
Out of bounds, last touch by Krauser. Coach Bray in his 4th season at Notre Dame, 20-plus wins and a trip to the NCAA tournament each year. But they'll have to hustle to keep both of those streaks alive. Jones got doubled. Francis banks it in. That's the way Jamie Dixon had them playing that in practice today, but he wants one of his men to recover more quickly to Francis than they did.
Well, absolutely, and Francis has shown the ability to hit that 12-footer. And really, again, Pittsburgh just thoroughly being outplayed right now. Nothing on defense seems to work, and offensively, Notre Dame has taken away just about every open opportunity.
Page a miss. Irish leading 15-2. The only loss of the season for Pitt was at Connecticut. They had to dig out of a big early hole here tonight to avoid loss number 2. Krauser looks to Jamie Dixon, who holds up 3 fingers. Krauser, sophomore from the Bronx. And a long 3 with Thomas not far off.
That's what Kyle Krauser brings to the table. Brandon Knight was a terrific point guard for this team, but he didn't have the ability to score from all places on the floor as Krauser does in a consistent basis. And obviously when your defense breaks down, it's up to your point guard to get something started.
Francis swatted by Taft. His 52nd block shot of the year, then a miss by Jordan Cornett. Pittsburgh in transition. Page strong to the bucket.
Now you've seen a much more aggressive Pittsburgh team. Instead of settling for the jump shots, starting to put it on the floor, forcing the Notre Dame defense to start to play it.
Five straight points for Pitt to quiet this capacity crowd. Fourth sellout of the year here at the Joyce Center. Francis, a sophomore from Boston, picked it out to Jones. And the rebound, Taft. He's averaging 7 rebounds and 11 points per game. A great candidate for Freshman of the Year, Rookie of the Year in the Big East. Out of bounds, last touched by Notre Dame.
Well, again, the breakdown in the Pittsburgh defense is their hallmark. Take a look at the screen right there. Hold it. The help should be coming across here. These guys should come across and help. Instead, everybody stands and watches. Francis receives too late. You know, the hallmark of the Pittsburgh defense is that they bring guys into the paint and they force you to do something else. They show and dissuade guys from putting it on the floor and getting good shots. That time, everybody stayed at home and they got hurt.
We watched Jamie Dixon and his staff work on that Notre Dame offensive set, work against it in their practice this morning over and over again. They played it a lot better in the walkthrough this morning than they did on that play. Tom Timmermans has come in for the Irish, and Colin Falls is in as well. Falls defending Page on this drive, and he pushed him out of bounds.
And again, Pittsburgh continues to attack. They're starting to get back into this ball game on the offensive end because they're making Notre Dame play and forcing the issue.
Jamie Dixon, first year head coach at age 38, 12 years of Division I assistant before getting this opportunity, and he's proven that it's pretty easy to be a head coach. 21-1. Brown rattles one in off a handoff from Torrey Morris. Morris 55 and Mark McCarroll 21 have come off Coach Dixon's bench.
Well, Torrey Morris made that play with a strong offensive rebound in a crowd.
Falls, a good outside shooter, and he's been hot lately. They're hoping for more offense from him. They don't have many solutions offensively. Falls capable of being one. Thomas lays it in.
And that's a point that Chris Thomas has to get over with regard to not being able to put the ball on the floor. Mike Gray told us before that he wants his guys to now start putting the ball on the floor. Everybody's playing Chris Thomas for the jump shot. He's got tremendous athletic ability. He might as well take advantage of it.
McCarroll missed as he tried to feed Jerron Brown. Scrum in the backcourt and a timeout called by Pittsburgh after Antonio Graves picked up the ball on the floor.
But that was great hustle by Graves. And in fact, Thomason hustling back touched the ball, and that negated the backcourt violation that was about to occur.
Mike Bray hollering at the officials and wanting an explanation about why that wasn't a backcourt call.
Thomas touched it.
That's probably what John Cal is telling him. Tomorrow, Shaq, Kobe expected return, and Gary Payton all in action against Orlando. And the Magic, Stacey McGrady's missed the last two with back spasms. That's tomorrow at 12:30 Eastern on ABC. And there's more NBA action on ESPN at 3 Eastern. The Seattle Supersonics try to climb into the Western Conference playoff race against the Portland Trailblazers. They've won 8 of the last 10 against Seattle. The NBA at 3 Eastern time tomorrow on ESPN. For more, log on to ESPN.com.
It's a mean-looking leprechaun right there.
Instance. Brown plays it into Page out there with Graves, a freshman. Morris and McCarroll. Jordan Cornette's come back in after a brief breather for Notre Dame. Morris, a nice baseline jumper. His first bucket, he averages 2 points per game. The senior from Oliver Springs, Tennessee. He, Brown, and Page, their last chance to win in this building. They're the three seniors. And a three for Colin Falls.
That's what Colin Falls brings to the game. He's a long-range shooter. Has been hot. This is 24 of his last 57.
Span that covers the last 14 games. Page in the lane. Knocks down that mid-range jumper that so few seem to have in this day and age.
And really, he hadn't been relying on it. He was looking for the alley-oop or looking for the three. Hence, he was in a terrific slump as well over the last several games.
Timmermans. From the Netherlands, nice baseline drive.
Well, that's quite the matchup. Timmermans believe that he is quicker than Torrey Morris. Both of them are biggest sequoias.
Timmermans 6'11", Morris at 6'10". They both go at 270 pounds plus. The skip to Page. Cornette ran out on him. And Jerron Brown scores inside to get the Panthers within seven.
Boy, an underrated player in Jerron Brown. You've got to figure out how he even got that shot off behind the basket. But at 6'4", he's got that 6'8 wingspan. That helped an awful lot.
Underrated is Brown, but less than he used to be. He is starting finally to get the attention that he deserves. Fouls on Torrey Morris. And a timeout. Len's all Big East team. We look forward to that when we come back.
Meanwhile, on the fourth floor.
When?
20 minutes ago.
An internet worm.
And a sneaky one, too. Came from the inside.
But the guys from IT said we're safe.
It was caught by the network, automatically. They say we're fine.
How does something like that get in here?
Hey, Daddy, I downloaded a new game on your computer. It's really cool.
Protecting networks and everyone around them. This is the power of the network. Now.
I got you something.
Hmm? Oh, you shouldn't have. Oh, this is nice. And here's yours. I know it's not fancy, but it's what's inside that counts. And what's inside is Labatt Blue.
Wow.
Huh?
I love it.
Break out the blue. Labatt Blue.
Awesome gift.
Oh, yeah.
Why so grumpy, Mr. Frumpy?
That was the worst meeting this week.
No, we've had worse.
You forgot the presentation.
Yeah, but I brought the bag.
You couldn't answer any of that question.
Sometimes it's what's not said that's important. Let me show you something. Now, see, I didn't say something. Did you feel that?
Why did we even come on this trip?
$39.99 a day or less for any compact car at Budget. For irresistible prices on irresistible cars, call 1-800-BUDGET-7 or visit budget.com.
Stop jumping on the bed. Stop jumping on the bed.
You'd be happy, too, if you saved up to 75% on your hotel. Fly, sleep, drive cheap.
Got athlete's foot? Think fast. Lamisil AT cures athlete's foot with just 1 week's use. If you use Tenactin or Lotrimin AF, you'll be treating for 4 long weeks. But 1 week with Lamisil AT keeps you athlete's foot free for 3 months. There's no better way to cure athlete's foot.
On the strength of 4 3-point field goals already, Notre Dame leads Pittsburgh by 7 as we conclude Rivalry Week presented by Cisco Systems with this game tonight. Getting toward that time of the year, we start to look ahead toward the end of the season awards, and you've already started to think about your All-Big East team.
Right. For right now, obviously, Emeka Okafor, Akeem Warwick, those are known quantities. Ryan Gomes is second in the conference in scoring, second in rebounding. But Bryant Matthews is the guy that plays for the last place, or next to last place team. Terrific. Leads the conference in scoring in the top 10 in a number of other categories. Andre Barrett having a terrific year at the point, which leads one to wonder why Chris Thomas isn't on. And Chris Thomas hasn't been as consistently dominant as he has been in the past. But more importantly, I just think that Andre Barrett is having a better year overall, leading the conference in assists, in the top 10 in scoring, really making his team go.
A kick ball by Quinn after the third Notre Dame turnover of the night. Well, Thomas was preseason All Big East first team and a unanimous selection, but he has not had as good a year as he had last year. Of course, after last season, here comes Quinn after the takeaway. He thought about going into the NBA draft, decided against it. Mike Bray says he's pretty certain that that won't be an issue at all at the end of this year, that Chris Thomas is well aware now that he needs to come back for his senior season to get ready to be an NBA player. He's not ready right now.
And those all-conference teams are obviously snapshots. When you look at it overall, Chris Thomas is just tremendously gifted. He does so many things on the floor. Just not having the shooting year that he had in the past and really that he's capable of having going forward.
And in defense of Chris in that area, Mike Bray also said he's had a little bit of a sore knee, as Thomas, that to his credit he hasn't used as an alibi. And that might require an arthroscopic procedure at the end of the year. Page missed a baseline shot, and Timmermans The rebound, Irish by 7, under 8.5 left in the first half. Sean McDonough and Len Elmore, our producer Bo Garrett, and our director John McDonough, delighted to have you with us.
And as you see, Chris Quinn is leading the offense, bringing it up. He's the playmaker, and I think that will help Chris Thomas, take some of the playmaking responsibility off his shoulders so he doesn't have to have judgment in making plays as well as scoring, and just allow him to do what he does best with the ball in the basket.
And that unlucky is his three rattled out. 8 minutes to go, first half here at the sold-out Joyce Center. Rivalry Week presented by Cisco Systems. Pittsburgh and Notre Dame, it's become a terrific rivalry in recent years. They would battle each other for the Big East West Division title. Of course, this year they've folded back into one conference of all the Big East teams. And they've played some memorable games in recent years, and this is a rivalry that has really developed under the Big East umbrella.
But at last, Pittsburgh possession, very uncharacteristically impatient. Just a couple of dribbles and a jump shot by Krauser. They've got to start moving the ball again.
Cornette gets that three ball to stay down. Jordan Cornette starting to give the Irish more offense. And if he can continue that down the stretch, it'll really help their postseason aspirations. And a mini timeout called by Jamie Dixon.
But Jordan Cornette, as you mentioned, has really been strong for the Irish, averaging about 9 points, 8 rebounds over his last three, including coming into this game 6 of 12 from beyond the arc. And known as a shot blocker, he's got tremendous touch from outside. And at 6'9", not a lot of people are going to get the ball, get the hands in his face.
Well, generally, as Chris Thomas goes, so go the Irish. He's off to a great start, 11 points on 3 out of 4 from beyond the arc.
And he just looks so much more relaxed. Two times he's used a lot of screens to get open, shot wide open, shot with guys in his face. And he doesn't seem to be as rushed or as anxiety ridden as he has been in the past, and trying to make plays, trying to get others involved. He's just focusing on shooting.
He also has one assist. He needs one more to tie David Rivers at 586 career assists for the all-time Notre Dame lead. So by the end of the night, he should be all alone as number one in assists for the Irish. Krauser off to a slow start. Taft rebounded his miss. Great pass down to the baseline to Troutman by Krauser for two.
And again, Pittsburgh settling for that jump shot. It's surprising because they've got a guy like Chris Taft inside that they need to at least explore. Fortunately, they got an offensive rebound and able to make the play.
Orion Jones, a senior from Morrisville, Pennsylvania. Strong drive. And even with Taft over trying to block the shot, Torian altered the shot and scored.
I wonder how many pumps he had on that one. At least two before he could get it up on the glass.
First bucket of the night for Torian Jones, who averages 9 per game. Here's Thomas. Quinn steps into a three, way off. Air ball, in fact. And a timeout with 6:08 left in the first half. All Notre Dame here early as rivalry week continues. And a flourish for Torian Jones to give them that 10-point edge.
The clinic will take place at the Moffitt Sports Center. For more information, contact...
I got you something.
Hmm? Oh, you shouldn't have. Oh, this is nice. And here's yours. I know it's not fancy, but it's what's inside that counts. And what's inside is Labatt Blue.
Wow.
Huh?
I love it.
Break out the blue. Labatt Blue.
Awesome gift.
Oh, yeah.
One time.
Who don't want to be the Williams sister? I know I do.
One night.
I'm full figure.
One room.
Your impressions of the people around you.
Hear the world's winningest athletes. Relaxed.
Yeah. Well, ask that one again, huh?
Candid.
The game has a great way of humbling you at any moment.
Revealing.
When it becomes personal and it's so close, I can care less what people think at that time.
All exclusive with Ahmad Rashad. Friday at 9 on ESPN.
Is Angela home?
What's that?
Chicken fingers from Matt's House of Chicken.
She's not feeling well.
I'm here for Angela. I've got chicken tips from Chicken Chicken.
You just missed her.
Yo, Angela.
What's in the bag?
Homestyle chicken strips from Wendy's.
Great. I didn't catch your name.
Snake.
Angela, snake's here.
Wendy's new homestyle chicken strips, tender strips of whole breast filet with homestyle breading and a delicious sauce. It's better here.
So, snake, I can see why Angela's crazy about you.
White Base Lake Placid, the number one ski resort in the eastern U.S. Number one, again, again, and again. Come to the Adirondacks and see why.
Also from the Big East tonight, Rutgers taking on Seton Hall, an improving Seton Hall club. They're up 28-17. Andre Barrett gets banged a few times, then does his own banging from three. Blowout city so far, Sean.
Seton Hall with the upper hand, Ravi, in the Battle of New Jersey. And Seton Hall, people tend to forget about them, but they're right there in the mix near the top of the Big East standings, shared at the top at the moment by Pittsburgh and Connecticut. But obviously, if Pittsburgh could win this game, they move a half game ahead of the Huskies, who are victorious today against West Virginia.
Well, again, you talk about Seton Hall, a team on the move. And as I mentioned before, that's why I put Andre Barrett on my all Big East squad, because he's the catalyst for that.
Kyle Ravitch made your team look pretty good with that clip that he selected for us to show you. First team all Big East guard Barrett made a long ball.
I'm glad they're listening on that.
Brown with the shot clock at 10. Krauser, the runner. Boy, it was wise to get rid of that when he did, Len, because there were shot blockers coming, but they were surprised by how quickly he let that fly in the middle of the lane.
And that's terrific point guard play. When the clock's running down, you got to create for yourself or for someone else. Not too many guys have that capability.
Krauser just 2-for-7 shooting with that bucket. He has 5 points. Rick Cornett has come in for the first time for Notre Dame, number 11. Not related to Jordan Cornett. They spell the last names differently. Rick Cornett almost turned it over. Jordan saved it for him. Quinn's runner rattles out. And the rebound down to Jerron Brown, the senior from Lexington, Kentucky. Taft. And to me, that's the whole key the last 3 years, Len, to Pittsburgh's tremendous success. Great interior passing. As good as any college team that I can recall in recent years, and Troutman the beneficiary there.
And I agree, and it was not only the great interior passing, it's also the unselfishness, because Taft could have gone up, tried to force the issue himself, but instead opted to give it to the open man.
Thomas, no good. There's Rick Cornett, who doesn't play very much, just ripping it away from two Panthers, from Page and Taft. Jones off a Quinn pass.
Exactly a terrific and accurate three-point shooter, only 24% coming into this game, but wide open. Excellent rotation. That's what confidence will do for you.
And that's just his seventh made three-pointer of the year. Notre Dame by 9, under 4 minutes to go in the first half. And a turnover as Troutman's pass was not handled by Jerron Brown. The Fighting Irish, red hot from the floor, shooting 52% and 50% from three. They lead by 9.
We get writer's block just like anybody else does. You just have to work through it.
Stink. Stink.
Done. 5 minutes.
Good. Great.
Deadline's looming. Pressure's intense.
Got the opening yet?
I'm gonna need a minute.
You just look to find a moment of inspiration.
What rhymes with Gagne?
It's magic when you find that right word and it just fits that thing.
If you were writing a story on the BCS, how would you start it?
Excuse me. I'll wait.
Yes. Meanwhile, in Dad's office.
I'll be right back, honey.
Defending the network from human nature. This is the power of the network, now.
The praise that Mazda 6 has received for applying sports car engineering to a sedan will appeal to all sorts of people. For the safety conscious, the highest government safety rating. For the consumer minded, the highest rated midsize sedan among owners. And 50 international awards for the speed readers. The Mazda 6. Lease a new 2004 Mazda 6i for $219 a month for 48 months with $2519 due at lease signing.
Halftime report. If you have not seen the end of that Stanford-Arizona game, must-see TV. Unbeaten, but barely. Meantime, St. Joe's continues to roll along. They're not unbeaten, but barely. They are very unbeaten. Also ahead, the Soaring Hawks and UConn. Mecca Okafor, another big game as he's part of Len's Big East team. Lenny?
All right, Carl, we'll look forward to that. We'll look forward to seeing Connecticut on Big Monday, presented by Bud Light, this Monday night here at Notre Dame. Jamie Dixon isn't looking forward to looking at these numbers when we arrive at the half. Defense, one of the hallmarks of Pittsburgh, and way off their usual defensive numbers tonight.
Well, right now, Notre Dame's on pace to score in the 80s, and against Pittsburgh, only Miami has done that this year, and it took them two overtimes to get there and still lost.
Only two other teams have scored, as Cornette traveled, more than 70 points. Mike Bray's team was one of them in their 74-71 loss at Pittsburgh. The only other team to score 70 plus against Pittsburgh in 22 games this year was Georgetown College. Not the Hoyas, Georgetown College. Troutman. Fouled. As we mentioned, Big Monday coming your way. Right here at the Joyce Center, the fifth-ranked UConn Huskies at 7 Eastern time, taking on the Fighting Irish at 9 Eastern. Kansas will take on their second-ranked Big 12 opponent in 3 days as they visit Oklahoma State. That's available on ESPN HD. Call your local cable operator, DirecTV, or the Dish Network today. Big Monday presented by Bud Light. Troutman, just a 57% career free throw shooter, and that's amazing because he's 66% from the floor for his career and 67 this year.
The free throw line's a little bit further from the goal than he's accustomed to on the offensive end.
Even with that unique delivery, I'm sure he's tried a lot of things because of his free throw woes. Nothing doing that trip to the line for Troutman, 0 for 2. Timmermans off a nice pass from Jones.
And again, Notre Dame working their strategy to perfection. Mike Bray said he wanted his guys to be aggressive, put it on the floor, wanted to push the ball up the floor to make Pittsburgh's bodies move on defense rather than get caught in a half-court grind-it-out type of game. They've spread the floor, they've gotten some guys open, and they've been able to deliver.
Page, a quick catch and shoot for three. Julius Page. He's their team leader in three-point field goals made. That's his first tonight, 42nd of the season for the senior from Buffalo. Jordan Cornette out there with Quinn, Thomas, Timmermans, and Jones. Brown poked it out of bounds. 16 to shoot for Notre Dame.
And this is a good opportunity now for Notre Dame to continue, get the ball to Chris Thomas, set some screens, and get some people moving again because he's in a groove right now.
What's interesting is you say that, and Timmermans knocks the Thomas miss out of bounds. He was clearly in a groove at the very beginning of the game, but now he hasn't taken many shots. That was just his seventh shot of the half, and he was 3 for 3 almost right off the opening tip.
Well, I think he's allowing the game to come to him, and that's been one of the problems with him in the past, that he's been forcing the issue. You know, he's going to get his points because he's going to get enough looks he can create enough for himself. The idea is to let the game flow, get other people involved, and that'll make it easier for him, and I think that's what he's tried to do the last couple of minutes.
Baseline jumper too strong from Mark McCarroll. It got deflected to Jones with a minute 40 left in the half. foul called away from the ball. No one seems to know what this foul is. And it's against Pittsburgh, so that satisfies Mike Bray. He had his arms outstretched as if to say, what is that? Now Jamie Dixon has the same question for Tony Green. They called a foul on Mark McCarroll. His first foul. Just the third on the team. And a timeout. As Notre Dame had a tough time getting the ball in. We mentioned that this has become a heated rivalry with some great games in recent years. Last February 9th, a classic here at the Joyce Center. Less than 40 seconds to go. Pittsburgh down by three, but Brandon Knight tied it at 64 with that one. The Irish were undaunted. Chris Thomas found Taryn Francis, who laid it in with 0.6 seconds left. And Notre Dame had its fifth straight win against Pittsburgh here at the Joyce Center. Two-point win. Stan stormed the court. And Francis averaging nearly a double-double for the season at 15.5 points and 9.5 rebounds.
Yeah, he's one of those guys who should get strong consideration for all conference as well, having a heck of a year.
Watch as Mike Montgomery's club trying to break that streak of home losses to Arizona and stay unbeaten for the season. Mustafa Shakur, Hassan Adams going up. Stanford's up, but only by two. Salim Stoudemire had 24. It tied at 67, and the unbeaten streak's in jeopardy, especially with Arizona now up three. Defense, no sir. Zona back up by five. Now it's a 77-74 game. Arizona gets sloppy. Josh Childress played a phenomenal game inside and outside. Here a three ties it. Arizona would come up with one last stand.
One-on-one with Lonick. Lonick stays. Almost stolen. They've got it. 2 seconds. Robinson at the buzzer. Yes! 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 Robinson at the buzzer! Luka nails it! Stanford stays unbeaten! It's a mob scene!
They never got their last shot off. Instead, it was a Stanford steal and a Stanford bucket. Stanford snaps that four-game home losing streak against the Wildcats. They're 12-0 at home this season, a 20-0 start, matching the best in school history. And they have now run off 20 straight in a row. Stanford by three over Arizona. Here's your hero.
Matt Lodick was playing really good defense on Salim. He brought him to the screen. And all of a sudden the ball was loose. I'm not for sure if Matt hit it or I hit it, but as soon as I caught it, I turned around and looked at the clock, saw there was 2 seconds, and just took it as fast as I could and let it fly.
And it found the bottom of the net. Speaking of finding the bottom of the net, St. Joe's is doing it with regularity. Can they keep pace with Stanford and stay unbeaten?
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of NCAA basketball, brought to you by Mazda. There's a soul of a sports car in everything we make.
So just when I'm thinking, isn't there a car out there I could get excited about? Wham! There's this car with all this stuff. Then as I'm thinking, now here's a car I could see myself in. Wham! There's this other car with all this stuff. And just as I'm thinking, how could this possibly get any sweeter?
The all-new Mazda 3 and Mazda 3 5-door. Some. Rethink what's possible.
Hey, guys, meet the new guy.
Hey. Hi, I'm Bob Holtkamp.
Hey, help yourself to some snacks.
Speaking of which, you know what would taste good about now?
Yeah, a big, hot and juicy cheeseburger.
With everything.
I can almost taste it.
Telling me, if there are a place to get a hamburger that good this late, I'd not only drive, I'd buy.
Really?
Wendy's classic hamburgers are made fresh, so they're always hot and juicy, so you can eat great even late.
You must be the new guy.
Yeah, thanks.
Wendy's, it's better here.
A year ago, over 10,000 hopefuls gathered with a dream of becoming an anchor on ESPN SportsCenter.
For a dream job, baby!
Welcome to the big show.
First quarter action.
We went 3-for-3.
Locked up in a tight one.
16 points in the first half.
Back to you guys.
Now, only 12 remain with a chance to claim the best seat in the world of sports as their own.
A little bit of a ram-a-lam-a-ham-dam.
ESPN's dream job. Watch one fan's dream become a reality. Series premiere Sunday, February 22nd, 10 p.m. on ESPN. Sponsored by Mazda 3.
Welcome to the Budget Rent-A-Car Halftime Report.
32-26, the Fighting Irish on top of the Pittsburgh Panthers. Things get a little tough for Pittsburgh here. A couple of big games coming up for them. They are down by 6 at the break, thanks to Chris Thomas's 11 points. But we've already seen Stanford stay unbeaten. Now St. Joe's turn, and Phil Martelli's getting all sorts of phone calls from guys who want to come and see this team play. Martelli says, forget the unbeaten streak, forget the phone calls. We have three games coming up against the teams that handed us losses last season. First things first, trying to stay unbeaten. There's the man. He's the guy getting all those calls. Larry Boa, Andy Reid, Eagles coaches, Phillies coaches. Jameer Nelson's over 20 in this one. St. Joe's up early. Stephen Smith with a huge alley-oop, and LaSalle hanging around, down just two. But St. Joe's pulls away. Their shooting has been outstanding, and they extend their school record start to 20-0 with their fifth straight win over LaSalle. Delonte West goes for 22, the 42nd player in school history with 1,000 points. They're still unbeaten. Connecticut's lost a few this season, but they're starting to play real good ball. Ben Gordon hitting the outside shot. Huskies up 5 at the half against West Virginia. Emeka Okafor, no answers for him. 49-36 in favor of the Huskies after he finishes there. Minute later, Huskies by 11. Gordon, the drive and the fade, and it falls. He went for 24. Connecticut is 13-1 at home. They win big, 88-58. Check on Syracuse and Providence, also from the Big East. Pick it up in the second half. Providence up big. Friars, Donnie McGrath with a long three. 49-36. Later in the second, part of a 22-7 run. Jake Ukabe drains a three. He'd do it again. Providence went up 55-36. This is a team that has struggled all time against Syracuse at home. No problems at the Dunkin' Donuts Center. McGrath sealing the deal with another long three. He hit 4 in the second half. The Friars as a team hit 8 in the second half. Syracuse has lost 2 in a row, and they have lost 4 of 5 overall. Other Big East scores, Seton Hall right now at the break, up over Rutgers 44-26. Andre Barrett in double digits. Darius Wright's 33-25. He has led Miami to a halftime lead over Georgetown. Check on North Carolina and the Demon Deacons. It's the Wake Golden Black student section trying to watch and inspire Jamal Levy to go high. He had 19 for Wake. Carolina's lead is 31-18. Then Rashad McCann. So it's one of the bigger shots this season as Carolina knocked off UConn. Here's McCants again. This time it's Sean May. He had 13 in the second half. UNC is up 11. Raymond Felton playing well, 17 points. Wake, surprisingly, 1-4 against ranked teams this season. Carolina wins it 73-68. Welcome back, folks. Andre Emmett and company as Bob Knight takes his first trip out of Lubbock since the salad bar incident. We'll return.
This halftime report is presented by Budget Rent-A-Car.
Why so grumpy, Mr. Frumpy?
That was the worst meeting this week.
No, we've had worse.
You forgot the presentation.
Yeah, but I brought the bag.
You couldn't answer any of that question.
Sometimes it's what's not said that's important. Let me show you something. Now, see, I didn't say something. Did you feel that?
Why did we even come on this trip?
$149 a week for any compact car at Budget. For irresistible prices on irresistible cars, call 1-800-BUDGET-7 or visit budget.com.
Ain't nothing like the real thing, baby. Ain't nothing like the real thing. I've got your picture hanging on my wall, but it can't see. Come to me when I call your name. A real
get the real thing all the time with unlimited local and long distance calling. And get it for one low monthly price. The Neighborhood, built by MCI, where you can make as many calls as you want around town and across the country and never worry about the cost. See what unlimited calling can do for you. Call 1-800-JOIN-MCI and stay connected.
So just when I'm thinking, isn't there a car out there I could get excited about? Wham! There's this car with all this stuff. Then as I'm thinking, now here's a car I could see myself in. Wham! There's this other car with all this stuff. Two cars, the same, yet different. Kind of like those twins I met in Chicago.
The all-new Mazda 3 and Mazda 3 5-door. Rethink what's possible.
Women love chocolate for Valentine's Day.
Russell Stover is America's number one selling Valentine's chocolate for one simple reason. Great taste.
Oh, that's really good. I'm feeling a little guilty for eating it. That's how good.
Every woman loves chocolate, and chocolate loves us.
Flowers, maybe. Chocolate, definitely.
She'll know when she sees the bow that you have great taste. Give Russell Stover with the famous gold bow.
I want some Russell Stovers for my Valentine's gift.
Welcome back to the Budget Rent-A-Car Halftime Report.
Fans at the Fieldhouse, Allen Fieldhouse, had signs that read, "Red Rager," as Bob Knight comes in since the incident with his chancellor, David Smith. No suspension, just a little reprimand. Keith Langford locks down a three for Kansas. Second half, they're up 11. Mike Lee doing the same thing. Second half, Tech down 12, trying to come back. Marshall, quick pass. Here's your layup. Wayne Simeon goes for 22 and 17 rebounds. They didn't have an answer for him, and J.R. Giddens hits a three from the corner. 23-game Big 12 home win streak intact as Kansas rolls 96-77. Louisville up on UAB, 61-48 in the second half with about five to play. Whitehead has got 11 and 15 rebounds, and a good game as well for Cincinnati by three over Houston. Jason Maxiel goes for 14. They've only lost once to the Cougars. They are 21-1 lifetime against them. Check on South Carolina and the catch. Gerald Fitch wasn't playing. Antoine Barber is. Kentucky up 62-60 as Azubuikwe goes downtown. Mike Boynton then drains the three for South Carolina on the ensuing trip down. South Carolina goes up 63-62. Boynton went for 12. Here's Antoine Barber doing some business on the baseline. Kentucky up 65-63 after the free throw. Eric Daniels goes for 17 in this one. Kerbal Brown misses the jumper, and Kentucky hangs on and wins by one. They're in first in the SEC East right now. They've won 15 of the last 16 meetings with South Carolina. Mississippi State's a real good team, folks. 80-56 over Ole Miss. Lawrence Roberts goes for 24. They got a six-game winning streak just underway. 11 minutes to go in half number one. Florida by three over Vanderbilt as a couple of top 25s battle. Don't forget, college game night, 12:30 a.m. Eastern time tonight. Iowa, Indiana, buzzer beaters and great finishes in this one. Gracie Wright hit a three to tie it at 80. Second overtime, Brody Boyd runner. And Indiana's last-ditch attempt, not to be. 84-82, Iowa is the winner. Georgia Tech over Tennessee, 77-62. And it was Northwestern, perhaps the surprise of the day, knocking off the Badgers of Wisconsin, 69-51. Chris Thomas did his work early in the first half. He's got 11 at the break, and it is Notre Dame by six. Second half, coming up.
This halftime report is presented by Budget Rent-A-Car.
Hi, I'd like a wake-up call, please.
Okay, you could have paid up to 75% less for your room with Hotwire. How's that for a wake-up call?
Fly, sleep, drive. Cheap.
Hotwire.com.
You'd expect a luxury sedan to have aerodynamic lines. But Lexus engineers went a step further. Dimpled panels were used on the undercarriage to reduce noise and lower wind resistance. So it's aerodynamic from every angle.
Show her that every day is Valentine's Day with this 1-carat baguette and round diamond heart. For just $1.99, exclusively at Zales, making moments last a lifetime.
Hey,
2. U.S. Navy SEALs. Rated M for mature.
Objective completed.
IO Digital Cable Service from Cablevision is here with the biggest and best in home entertainment. IO offers over 200 exciting channels, including up to 50 movie channels, and more than 700 on-demand titles each month that you can start anytime. Best of all, IO is only $9.95 more per month. It's bigger than TV, better than satellite TV. It's the best value in home entertainment. TV is now IO, digital cable service from Cablevision. Call today, 1-866-30-DIGITAL.
Country Ford presents the Jiffy Lube Monster Jam. Brought to you by Advance Auto Parts and Ford Trucks. With Dennis Anderson in the legendary Grave Digger. And more. Plus freestyle motocross. And every kid seat is still half price. Get behind the scenes at the Built Ford Tough Party in the Pits. Grab your free pit pass at Country Ford. And while you're there, test drive the next F-150. And get a kid's ticket voucher to Monster Jam. Tonight at 8 and tomorrow at 2. Nassau Coliseum.
Matter.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of NCAA basketball brought to you by Hotwire.com. Get a four-star hotel for a two-star price at Hotwire.com. And Lexus and their passionate pursuit of perfection.
We're back on the campus of Notre Dame with the Fighting Irish lead Pittsburgh at the half, 32-26. And we check our ESPN2 game track. Great start for Notre Dame. They got off to a 15-2 lead paced by Chris Thomas, who hit his first three-point tries.
And then the Pittsburgh defense, early porous by their standards, tightened, able to swarm people, and on the offensive end, able to get the ball inside, start getting those high percentage shots that they're accustomed to.
One potential problem for Notre Dame, Taryn Francis, their center, who averages 15.5 points and 9.5 rebounds per game, played just 9 minutes in the first half, and we found out at halftime he has back problems and he's not going to start the second half.
Well, that's going to have obviously a terrific impact, adverse impact on the Irish unless they find a way to adjust. We talked about the Pittsburgh defense again. The last 3 minutes and 4 seconds held Notre Dame without a field goal. You know, that was the point in time when I thought again that Notre Dame was going to get at least 40 for the half and play that 80-point type of game, but Pittsburgh clamped down.
Pittsburgh's ball to begin the second half. Carl Krauser guarded by Chris Thomas. Here's Chris Taft guarded by Tom Timmermans, who's in for Francis. Siobhan Troutman, now Julius Page. And the other starter in the second half for Pittsburgh is Jerron Brown, the same five that started the game, starts the second half. Krauser spins one in.
Well, that's where the absence of Taryn Francis, a terrific shot blocker, gives Pittsburgh a little bit of confidence. They're now starting to put the ball on the floor and attack the basket.
Chris Quinn did not make a shot in the first half. And 0 for 4 from the floor. Timmermans to Thomas, Torian Jones and Jordan Cornett, the other second half starters for the Irish. Eight to shoot. Jones working on Page to the left, and he managed to get it up over Taft for two.
Well, we talk about the versatility of Torian Jones, usually known as a defender, but the last couple of times he's had his hands on the ball, he's been an acrobat.
With 7 points tonight, he averages 9 a game. Brown to Page. On the low block, the jump hook wouldn't drop for the freshman Taft. Brown ripped it away from Jones, and then Brown was fouled.
Talked about Francis being out of the game, opening up some driving lanes for Pittsburgh. Carl Krauser wasted no time into taking it straight to the basket. No big man back to defend.
Mike Gray was up off the bench after that play. He thought Krauser pushed off.
And here's Torian Jones again with a nice spinning move in the paint, using his length to score.
Here's Brown. Makes the first one. Mike Gray thinks part of Pittsburgh's success is even though they lose players, as they did last year with Brandon Knight and Ontario Ladd and Donatus Zavascus all using up their eligibility, they remain an older team. Brown, for example, is 24 years old. And certainly that kind of experience, both in life and on the court, helps.
And maturity, and that's what happens, particularly when you come down to a point where you have to remain poised under pressure.
A 4-point lead for the Irish.
Nice head there by Siobhan Troutman to stop Thomas's push towards the baseline. I'm sorry, towards the sideline.
Taft called for bodying up on Timmermans and a mock cheer from the crowd. The officials let him play in the first half. And only a total of 7 fouls called. Neither team got near the limit. Thomas, the pull-up. He was fading away out of that shot when he didn't have to. He had some room to go straight up. Krauser off to Troutman.
And that's why Krauser's called Black Magic. Picked up that nickname on the playgrounds in the Rucker tournament in New York City. Does a lot of things deftly with the ball.
It was a 13-point lead for Notre Dame, down to 2. Jones behind the bag a couple of times. And a foul called on Pittsburgh.
Again, we talk about the defense and Chris Thomas making decisions. Watch the step out by Chris Taft right there. Now Taft is going to continue and get his hands up. That just makes it a difficult shot for Chris Thomas. We talked about lapses in judgment. That's the time when you get a big man on you and you know there's a mismatch down low. Back it up, find the mismatch, and exploit it.
Thomas started out 3 for 3. He's 1 for 6 since. And a chance for a tie or the lead for Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh has never led. Taft stripped by Quinn. Out of bounds with 12 to shoot for the Panthers. They're off to their best start ever in Big East play at 7-1. They come in having won 3 straight games. 21 wins, the most in Division I. It's almost as if the official said, you know, we only called 7 fouls in the first half, so we're going to get our whistles working here in the second.
But the amazing thing is I thought there was a pretty good flow to the first half.
Yeah, they thought they did a great job.
Yeah, I mean, it's...
Apparently they didn't feel like there were enough of the action there in the first half.
Why mess with success?
They want their airtime. That would be the question I would raise. Foul was on Jordan Cornette. Here's Krauser for 3, and Pittsburgh leads for the first time tonight, 3 minutes into the second half.
And they've been able to get to this lead very methodically, playing strong defense, and now they're beginning to execute in the half court.
And we talk about the lack of depth for Notre Dame in scoring, and certainly Francis, one of their few scorers, being out hurts them.
NCAA Women's Basketball Championship begins March 20th.
Any driver can recognize their own car, but how many cars can recognize their driver? Smart Key Technology from Lexus.
When I first met my girlfriend, I didn't know what to say or what to give her. Now I've gotten better at both.
A 3-stone diamond necklace from Kay means 2 things. Every diamond is hand-selected, and she'll absolutely love it.
Every kiss begins with K.
Think of this as itchy, flaky dandruff, the kind that keeps coming back. Shut it down with Neutrogena T-Gel, the number one dermatologist-recommended shampoo to help keep persistent itching and flaking away. Shut dandruff down. Neutrogena T-Gel. It works.
For centuries, humans have tried but failed to retain worldly possessions when crossing over. Finally, Radio Shack has made it easy to change your wireless service provider without giving up your existing number.
Just bring us your current wireless bill and we'll take care of the rest. And right now, get a Samsung VI660 color screen phone for just $29.99 with 2-year agreement after instant rebates.
So, while we can't promise you immortality, we can make this life a little easier at Radio Shack.
Gators and Vandy's Kevin Stallings needs one win to get 200. Early on, though, Matt Walsh drains a three, and right now the Gators preventing Stallings from thinking about that milestone. They're up 5.
And here at Notre Dame, it's Pittsburgh by 1, their first lead of the night. They're on a 14-2 run since 3 minutes remain in the first half.
And Pittsburgh's aggressiveness to the basket. You're going to take a look at Chevy Troutman drive to the hole, forcing Notre Dame to pick its poison. Watch Chris Thomas right around in there. He's going to help out instead of step out to try to guard Carl Krauser. And that decision costs them. You either guard the shooter or you got to step in the way of the driver and make him stop.
Timmermans. Can he give them some offense in the absence of Francis? And it doesn't look like Francis is going to come back. There's Thomas with a long two. They're not even working on Francis on the bench. He's just seated there. And you can see he's flexing and kind of getting a comfortable position as he sits on the bench with that bad back.
He thinks he's coming back in, though. That's why he's trying to stretch it out.
Either that or just trying to be more comfortable as he sits. Troutman to Page. Page, Choi with a three, Taft with good position. And it's Pittsburgh again by 1.
And you're impressed by the way they just fight for a spot on the weak side glass.
It's the first basket for Taft. Thomas grabs a little too unselfish there. And now Krauser. 7 turnovers for the Irish. Taft has Quinn posted up underneath. He wanted it, but Krauser said we'll take 3 instead of 2. Boy, is this game turned around. And if Francis can't go back in for Notre Dame, things look bleak for them.
Well, again, they don't have that inside presence on the offensive end, a guy they can go to in a post-up situation and rely on for points. You're forced to go to Timmermans, who's just not a post-up player.
10 seconds to shoot. Notre Dame now down 4. 4 to shoot. Cornette has to shoot. Got no rim and a shot clock violation. Francis trying to get loose. His absence has turned this game completely around, or at least helped to do that. It's Pittsburgh leading by 4.
The island calls out to the NFL's best. These barons of the breakaway.
He's gone.
Rulers of reception.
Are you kidding?
The stores of the big play.
Oh, yeah. The guy can fly.
Pillars of protection.
Oh, man.
The Pro Bowl is on ESPN. Football is the great game. These are its greatest players. The 2004 Pro Bowl, Sunday at 7:30 on ESPN.
Meanwhile, on the 4th floor.
When?
20 minutes ago.
An internet worm.
And a sneaky one, too. Came from the inside.
But the guys from IT said we're safe.
It was caught by the network, automatically. They say we're fine.
How does something like that get in here?
Hey, Daddy, I downloaded a new game on your computer. It's really cool.
Protecting networks and everyone around them. This is the power of the network. Now.
You'd expect a luxury sedan to have aerodynamic lines. But Lexus engineers went a step further. Dimpled panels were used on the undercarriage to reduce noise and lower wind resistance. So it's aerodynamic from every angle.
If a movie about a guy digging a chick makes you feel like a pansy.
You're my boyfriend, right?
Uh-oh. Or a mama's boy.
That was pathetic.
Then there's always 50 first dates.
Are you staring at me or her? Because you're starting to freak me out.
This Friday.
Yeah.
50 first dates. Oh! Rated PG-13. Opens everywhere Friday.
Notre Dame down by four. The Irish 24-10 last season. They made it to the Sweet 16 for the first time since 1987. As a result of that success, ranked 19th in the preseason poll and picked to finish third in the Big East. I think those expectations were way too high, Len. You look at their team a year ago, sure they won 24 games, but they lost Matt Carroll and Dan Miller, who combined to score 33.5 points per game. Didn't really bring anybody in who could replace them.
Well, it certainly didn't. Obviously, people probably expected Taryn Francis, Chris Thomas, and Chris Quinn to really step up and fill that void and maybe get some guys off the bench as players. Torian Jones has given them a lot, but not enough, obviously, to stem the tide of losses. Conversely, though, Pittsburgh's a team that wasn't thought of highly, and they've been able to develop some players beyond Page and beyond Siobhan Troutman and Jerome Brown. You know, Chris Taft is a tremendous pickup for them as a freshman, giving them a total lift. So the experts aren't so expert.
Brown's three makes it a seven-point game. They're pulling away. Quinn had trouble on the dribble with Troutman defending. Quinn did well to get it back.
And you see the Pittsburgh defense even more animated. They have a tendency to understand when they have a team down and they step on them and not let them up.
Thomas is shot out of bounds. He may be trying to do a little too much now. Without Francis, you mentioned Pittsburgh. They were 22nd in the preseason rankings and picked to finish fourth in the Big East behind Connecticut, Syracuse, and Notre Dame in the coaches' poll. Both Connecticut's coach Jim Calhoun and Syracuse coach Jim Boeheim says this Pittsburgh team is better than last year's.
And I agree with them, and a lot of it, again, has to do with the inside presence of Taft and the development of Carl Krauser at the point.
It gives them more offense, more of a scoring mentality at the point than did the great Brandon Knight. Brought a lot to the table himself, certainly. Jones fouled. There was a six-point lead for the Irish, but their woes really began well before the end of that first half. No field goals the last 3:04, and the offensive struggles without Francis have continued.
And the difficulty is now they're turning to Torian Jones to be that third scorer, actually the second scorer, because Chris Quinn has really given him nothing, and Jones just not accustomed to being in that position.
I would assume Linda Francis, again, is not coming back, because I think if he's even pondering that, they'd be doing something, working on him to try to give him some treatment to get him back. Timmerman's called for a charge as he ran over Siobhan Troutman.
And again, you take a look, there's the help side finally coming over. We mentioned in the first half, too many guys buried on the weak side and not giving help. That was more indicative of the way Pittsburgh wants to play defense. Sacrificing your body, getting over and helping your teammates.
First foul on Timmermans. Pittsburgh with the ball and a seven-point lead, the eighth turnover by Notre Dame.
And I agree with you, Sean. Looking over there now, at one point I thought Taryn Francis was trying to get loose, trying to get in the game, but he seems very reconciled to being on that bench.
In a huge game for the Irish. Started out looking like they would have a shot. Had a much-needed win over a highly ranked opponent. Improved their NCAA resume. Thomas, the breakaway dunk.
Well, that time Carl Krauser got himself in trouble on the baseline. No one rotated back to protect as Krauser lost the ball. And they got the crowd back into it.
Yeah, the crowd had vanished, but they're trying to do their part to help out. This is Yuri Dimitris, who just came in for the first time tonight. Page, a runner, wouldn't go, following the rebounding action against Pittsburgh.
Again, Carl Krauser, we said, tremendously developed as a point guard, got in trouble, really had no outlet, and no one back. Dimitris should have rotated back. He was too late, and the athleticism of Chris Thomas got these people off their feet, and they haven't sat down yet.
First foul on Krauser on the rebounding action, the fourth against the Panthers. Big possession here. They're trying to build a little momentum with the house back into it. Krauser deflects it out of bounds. 21 seconds to shoot for Notre Dame.
And if you're the excellent defensive team in Pittsburgh, you look upon that as a challenge. The crowd gets into it. Team starts to make a run at you. You got to dig in somewhere, see if they're up to the challenge.
Cornett, a three that rattles out. Jones crashed the boards and had it with one hand, but then lost it as he hit the floor. Troutman. 3 second violation. 11:56 remaining in the second half. Pittsburgh has come from 13 down to take a 5-point lead.
Introducing the Nissan Quest, a revolutionary minivan featuring 5 Skyview windows, an innovative center console, automated side and rear lift doors, and fold-away second and third row seats. Moms have changed. Shouldn't the minivan? One time.
Who don't want to be the Williams sister? I know I do.
One night.
I'm full figure.
One room.
Your impressions of the people around you.
Hear the world's winningest athletes. Relaxed.
Yeah. Well, that way, you know.
Candid.
The game has a great way of humbling you at any moment.
Revealing.
When it becomes personal and it's so close, I can care less what people think at that time.
All exclusive with Ahmad Rashad, Friday at 9 on ESPN.
It's always the same dream. I'm standing on top of my building, and it starts to grow. It starts slow, then it gets faster. Clouds fly past me, and suddenly it's all a blur. The air gets colder and thinner, and I can't catch my breath. Mergers, acquisitions, network integration, one guy to sort it all out. Growth is supposed to be a good thing, right?
For over 5 decades, Cassone Trailer and Container Company has been the largest supplier of office trailers, ground-level containers, storage trailers on wheels, and guard booths. Why? Because Cassone can beat any price while offering exceptional personal service, and they'll do the same for you. Family-owned and operated since 1950, Cassone Trailers and Containers are clean, dry, and lockable. Cassone Trailer and Container Company is located at 1950 Lakeland Avenue in Ronkonkoma. Call 1-800-640-8844 or visit Cassone.com.
Matter.
Pittsburgh trying to go to 22-1 for the year, 8-1 in the Big East with a 5-point lead. Start of a critical stretch for Notre Dame, which continues with Big Monday presented by Bud Light. The fifth-ranked Connecticut Huskies will be here at the Joyce Center at 7 Eastern time, followed by Big 12 action between two top 20 teams, Kansas and Oklahoma State, available in ESPN HD at 9 Eastern time. Big Monday presented by Bud Light on ESPN. Pittsburgh tonight, Connecticut Monday, then Seton Hall, the only ranked team in a six-game stretch, the only unranked team, but a very good team at 14-5. Chance to play their way right back into the NCAA tournament picture. They're trying to do it tonight without Taryn Francis. And Jones tried to hit Cornett. I would assume he is really hurting talking about Francis then, because this is a huge game. He knows how much his team needs him. And for him not to try to go, I assume he's really in a great deal of pain.
Well, you see right there, he's trying to stretch it out. I know that when I have a little bit of a back spasm, I'm squirming in the seat trying to stretch the lower back. And you're right. I mean, I think that if he had an opportunity to play, they'd have him on the side. They'd be applying heat and stretching him out so that immediately he can step on the floor when he feels stretched out.
Demetrius. McCarroll inside, contested by Cornett. He made the shot nonetheless. Mark McCarroll, a junior from Queens, with his first bucket of the night. He averages 6 a game.
And he's one of those guys that has developed for Pittsburgh that really wasn't a factor last year. And this year he's come on and had some terrific games off the bench.
He has 134 points this season, does McCarroll. He scored 28 points all of last year. As a sophomore, in fact, he scored more points this year than his first 2 years at Pitt combined. He had a 26-point game this year against Georgia that nearly matched his season total from last year.
Two shots.
Jones at the line. Foul is on Demetrius, his first. during the last timeout, John Powell, the lead official, summoned both coaches to center court and appeared to be telling them that he didn't want to hear any more from either one of them, at least as much as he's been hearing about some of the calls and non-calls. Which surprised me, because I don't know if he's wearing particularly demonstrative, but we do have a headset right over there on the other side of the court. That's what they were told.
They've been demonstrative, but again, I don't think that the calls have been a factor. Both sides have to play a physical brand. You know, if anybody has an argument, it might be Mike Gray, because his team just doesn't want to compete in that type of physical game, and that's the way Pittsburgh plays.
Page, a nice high-arcing baseline jumper, and a lead up to 8 for the Panthers as we approach the midpoint of this second half.
But again, it's that one-on-one defense that Pittsburgh plays, usually without gambling, although that time Krauser stepped out of the D. And that's why they've been so successful, because they're tough.
Gentleman's powered his way to the bucket after rebounding to Thomas, missed but could not score. You also wonder about fatigue for Notre Dame. They're basically playing with 5 men without Francis. This same 5 has been out there just about the entire half. And a guy like Timmermans, who only averages 17 minutes per game, isn't accustomed to playing anywhere near this much. Offensive foul called against Pittsburgh. And Jamie Dixon did not heed the warning to remain quiet, but he was quite upset after that whistle.
Well, we talk about Julius Page and his athleticism, but there he shows you, as you mentioned in the first half, that mid-range game. You know, you combine the ability to shoot from beyond the arc, which Page does pretty well at 35%, his ability to get to the rim with a mid-range game, and it's pretty difficult to find a way to stop the young man.
Foul on Jerron Brown was his 4th, so he's gone to the bench. And the freshman Antonio Graves, number 22, is back in for Pittsburgh, a much deeper team than Notre Dame. Mike Gray off the bench. He thought Quinn got hammered. The crowd agrees. And now Krauser stopped on the drive by Timmermans. And the official Will Bush warns Timmermans.
First of all, Timmermans was dead wrong. That was the payback. There's the contact, and Quinn should have gotten something.
That's a foul.
Because the body was
Mike
there.
Gray jumped right up.
But on the other end, Timmermans essentially like a payback with the elbow right there. You know, maybe he's trying to make a statement for his team, but you got to be careful, especially when you're in the middle where the officials can see you.
Timmermans has been involved in some physical play in the past. Some opponents think approaches the edge. Now he gets called for a hard shove on Taft.
Well, see, Timmermans is trying to bait Taft right now. And I don't like that kind of basketball. Yes, you stop him, you put your body on him, but don't start staring him down, trying to bait the guy into some kind of altercation. Play basketball.
Timmermans comes out. He's the stand-in for Taryn Francis. It's Rick Cornett, who's played very little this year, who's in the ball game. He averages 6 minutes per game, and he has not appeared in every game. Page a miss. 9 minutes to go. Notre Dame down by 8. And a foul on a hand check gets a mock cheer from the crowd.
The Pittsburgh personal number 22.
And that's the team limit. 17 fouls. So one and one opportunity upcoming for Chris Quinn.
Chris Quinn at the line for the Irish, shooting 1 at the bonus.
Going back to the physical play, I don't mind physical play. As a matter of fact, I like to see guys bump within the rules. But once it's over, you know, don't try to escalate the situation by antagonizing, by instigating something beyond that.
Quinn, an 89% free throw shooter, makes both. And Notre Dame trying to hang in there, down by 6, under 9 minutes to go. Krauser with Page, McCarroll, Graves, and Taft. Krauser working on Jones. Blocked out of bounds. Hit ball, 17 to shoot.
Krauser also trapped into doing more than he's probably capable of against 2 and 3 white shirts there. Pittsburgh needs a little bit of ball movement.
Ten to shoot.
Here's where a point guard needs to create for others on penetration.
Defensive mix up there. Both Cornett and T. Thomas stayed up high, and that allowed Taft to roll to the bucket for the uncontested basket. And this is matching the largest lead for Pittsburgh at 8 points.
That's right. Notre Dame has got to talk.
McCarroll called for the foul, and another one-and-one opportunity.
Watch both defenders step up there. Chris Thomas, the only one back. He's not tall enough to catch that pass that was thrown up and above the head of Chris Taft.
Cornette missed the front end of a one-and-one. He's a 67% free throw shooter. That was Jordan Cornette. Sometimes it's hard to keep this team straight. You have a Turin and a Torian. You have two Cornettes. They're spelled differently. Both Chris's in the backcourt. Krauser. Wow. Sounds as if these officials now are looking for something to call after they weren't very involved in the first half. They did a great job in the first half, but they're determined to become a factor now, and both coaches are upset about it. A lot of Pittsburgh's recent success due to the New York City recruiting pipeline.
Meanwhile, in Dad's office.
I'll be right back, honey.
Defending the network from human nature. This is the power of the network now.
Introducing the Nissan Quest.
Hey, Bob. You get a new haircut?
No.
Hey, Bob.
Hey.
Did you lose weight?
Your jacket, Bob?
Nope.
What's different? He finally asked his doctor about Viagra. Ready to ask your doctor about Viagra for the first time? Find out if a free sample is right for you. To learn more, visit Viagra.com.
Call the sitter and walk the dog. That's not a doctor.
Ask your doctor and see the difference.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Rivalry Week is presented by Cisco Systems. This is the power of the network now, and in part by Nissan, who invites you to shift the way you move through the world.
We're back at the Joyce Center on the campus of Notre Dame, where Pittsburgh has come from a 13-point deficit very early, being an 8-point lead. And the last foul a moment ago called on Cornette during this scrum as he reached out for the foot of Krauser.
And there's a little ankle tackle right there. And that's what the officials saw. Krauser didn't go down, though.
And that's why I think the fans were upset. They didn't see it, nor did I. The grab around the ankle, but clearly it was a good call. And Cornette whistled for his third foul. Timmerman's back in.
That's a good move by Mike Gray, knowing he needs Timmerman's physical presence to get him on the bench to cool him down.
Taft over Jordan Cornette. A nifty bank, and it's the largest lead of the night for Pittsburgh.
And as we mentioned, they're not the type of team that's going to come at you and go on tremendous runs. They will build their leads methodically, using a half-court defense, gaining possession and execution on the offensive end to build leads.
Long three by Thomas. And a quick timeout called by Mike Bray.
Well, you talk about talent. Again, there's no defense for that type of shot. Chris Thomas just has it all together. He's just got to be able to put it all together. And again, look at the depth of that shot, about 3 feet off the three-point line. Not a whole lot you can do with that.
They mentioned heading to break the pipeline to Pittsburgh from New York City. Some great talent recruited out of the city. by the Panthers coaching staff, including Krauser, the freshman Taft out of Xaverian High School, Mark McCarroll and Dante Milligan, who's sitting out this year. Here's Barry Rorson, like Taft. He's a graduate of Xaverian, and he's the assistant foremost responsible for recruiting New York City, and what a great job he has done. And our colleague Digger Phelps mentioned Barry Rorson as a candidate for the St. John's head coaching job. But they've had a problem getting the best players out of the city, and the big key to turning that program around would be to keep them there. Why not a guy with a proven track record recruiting some of the best?
St. John's has had difficulty getting them because Barry's taken them all, and they got more coming, and Keith Benjamin, Ronald Ramon, and John DeGroat, three guys that are committed to Pittsburgh from the New York City area.
That's three more next year. Wow. Quinn bumped by Graves. Been a quiet night for Quinn in contrast to his recent successes. A sophomore, spent some time as a youth living in the Chicago area. He was a neighbor of Doug Collins and his family. And Doug and his son Chris, of course, played at Duke and knows Mike Bray very well. Mike, a former assistant at Duke. The Collinses gave Coach Bray a very strong recommendation on Chris Quinn when Chris was being recruited. Oh, a rare miss. Just his sixth miss from the line this year in 49 attempts. Strong drive by Krauser, and he's fouled by Thomas. First foul of the night on Chris Thomas.
That's another way to try to take Chris Thomas out of the game, make him play defense on the other end. Krauser using a nice little change of pace. You lull him to sleep with that slow dribble, and then you explode to the basket.
Krauser shooting two. Long with the first one, and he's a good free throw shooter at 79%.
One of the few for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, that could be a problem for them in tournament play. The Big East tournament or the NCAA. At 62% as a team. 7-point edge. 6.5 minutes remaining. Florian Jones lost it. Cornette picked it up, but then knocked it off his knee out of bounds.
Well, again, the swarming Pittsburgh defense. Ball goes inside. They collapse. Get those hands working.
Trouble getting it in, and Page asked for a timeout.
The Panthers call a 30-second timeout.
Tomorrow on ABC Sports, NBA action. Kobe Bryant expected to return to the Lakers and join Shaq and Gary Payton. They head into Orlando to take on the Magic. That's at 12:30 Eastern, 9:30 a.m. Pacific. Lakers have won 8 of the last 9 in that rivalry. And more NBA action on ESPN at 3 Eastern as Seattle tries to climb back into the Western Conference playoff picture against the Portland Trail Blazers. That's at 3 Eastern tomorrow on ESPN. Also a plug for ESPN2 women's action tomorrow. Marquette and DePaul will play tomorrow. That's at 4 Eastern, and that's of interest to Jamie Dixon because his sister Maggie is an assistant women's coach at DePaul. They are 19-2. Maggie is here tonight right behind the Pittsburgh bench. So brother Jamie needs a little more help. And what he's getting from his excellent coaching staff, he can turn right over his shoulder and look at his sister. Their only losses were to Tennessee in overtime and Charlotte for the fall women's team. Their men had a big win today over Marquette.
Yeah, they did. I mean, they came out really exploding offensively.
Antonio Graves, a one-handed runner, wouldn't go for the freshman. He comes back to him. And here's Thomas. Notre Dame still within striking distance, down by 7, despite very little offense since Taryn Francis left the game in the first half.
Well, that was a good decision by Chris Thomas to pull it back, try to set something. And they got an opportunity to get to the free throw line because of it.
Panthers personal foul, number one, Julius Page.
Julius Page called for the foul.
That's
the 10th team foul, the first personal on Page. So it'll be two shots the rest of the way for Notre Dame. There were 7 total fouls between the two teams in the first half. There have been 17 here in the second half, and still nearly 6 minutes to go.
Well, Torian Jones has become that second or third option right now, and he's starting to really get some confidence going to the basket, creating stuff for himself and other people. Obviously, you get to the free throw line, you got to capitalize on the easy ones.
Two misses, but Cornette rebounded the second. Chris Quinn, they need him to heat up. Not that time. Cornette again.
Well, you give Notre Dame a lot of credit. They're battling Pittsburgh on the glass, giving themselves extra opportunities.
Quinn is 0 for 6 from the floor. They've been red hot coming in. Thomas working on the freshman Graves. Zimmerman's could make it from out there. Cornette at his fingertips on another offensive rebound, but couldn't control it. Krauser left alone at the elbow. Fired up an air ball out of bounds. Last touch by Quinn.
Boy, Quinn lost that ball because the air ball caught him by surprise, as it did probably everybody else on the floor.
Krauser out to Graves. He didn't sign to come to Pittsburgh until late August. He was going to go to prep school, but Jamie Dixon saw him play over the summertime. Saw enough from him to have him come to Pitt. He had a scholarship available, a very late recruit. And Graves has been a nice role player off their bench. Taft over Jordan Cornette, Timmermans, and Troutman. And a foul called on Troutman.
Well, that's an excellent job by Cornette to maintain his position against Taft and make him shoot a tough shot. See him right there, just stayed on his feet, got a hand in his face. Taft misses badly. And as I mentioned, Notre Dame, they're not backing down off the glass. Good position, good battle by Timmermans that time. And if you're going to play physical, that's the way you need to play. That time, the contact was made. Timmermans goes to the ground, gets the foul call. He doesn't look and try to bait. Goes straight to the free throw line and drops one.
Timmermans, a 62% free throw shooter, made the first. They're looking at Torian Jones, perhaps for blood. Will Bush, one of the officials over there, scanning him. Notre Dame, for a while, was in the top 25 in the country in free throw shooting as a team at 79%. And since Big East play started, they've shot just 66% from the line. Another reason why they haven't fared well lately. Brown comes back in with his four fouls with 4:42 to go as Notre Dame has cut the deficit to 5.
And they've applied some full court pressure now that seems to be giving Pittsburgh pause to think.
And you wonder how much these Fighting Irish players have in the tank. It's been essentially this 5 the whole half, with a couple of minutes from Rick Cornette, and that's it.
Although you got to believe, if they're in condition with the television timeouts as well as the regular timeouts, they're only going 2 4-minute spurts.
Cornette can't control it.
Now, if they were hockey guys, it's a different story. You know?
Yeah, they'd be changing on the fly. 4:18 left, 11 to shoot for the Panthers. Page doesn't need the 11, and banks it home. They give Pittsburgh a 7-point lead.
Boy, Julius Page with that elevation, 39-inch vertical elevation on the jump shot. No one seems to be able to bother him on it.
4-year starter Julius Page. Tonight, career start number 115. Jones, they backed off him. He decided to drive on right around Taft underneath to score.
And that was good recognition by Jones. He saw Jerron Brown with four fouls guarding him, and he took the best route to the basket.
Crowd trying to get into it again. And Quinn called for a foul. 18 fouls, so it's a 1-1. Big Monday night presented by Bud Light. Connecticut's here at the Joyce Center to take on Notre Dame. Connecticut trying to keep pace with Pittsburgh atop the Big East. Then Kansas and Oklahoma State for the Big 12 at 9 Eastern time. For more information, log on to ESPN.com.
And how about Oklahoma State just climbing up top 25? They're doing it with solid defense as well.
Krauser made the first free throw. 15 points tonight, right on his average. And a media timeout. Well, we showed you last year's fantastic finish. Will we have another? Come back for it right after this.
Introducing the Nissan Quest, a revolutionary minivan featuring 5 Skyview windows, an innovative center console, automated side and rear lift doors, and fold-away second and third row seats. Moms have changed. Shouldn't the minivan?
They're coming! They're coming! Domino's Dots are coming!
Big flavors coming your way. Introducing cheesy Domino's Dots. Smothered in delicious Colby and Monterey Jack cheese. 360 degrees of all-around fun. Get an order of cheesy Domino's Dots for 99 cents when you buy any large one-topping pizza for $9.99. Now in a manageable size.
I don't know. They look pretty big to me.
Get the door. It's new cheesy Domino's Dots.
Okay, one more time. Where do we stand?
Less travel.
More video conferences.
Limit the cell phone minutes.
That's not good enough. We're not leaving this room unless we can cut something else.
Can they really keep us here?
What about all this stuff?
What stuff?
All this stuff. What does it cost to create all this? Time, effort, people.
How much?
It could be millions.
Millions.
Pushing myself to the limit is what this is all about. And I need an antiperspirant that can keep up. That's why I use High Endurance Clear Gel. Try it. If you don't like it, Old Spice will buy you a stick of something else. A clear gel that strong? I'm there. Old Spice High Endurance Clear Gel.
Got athlete's foot? Think fast. Lamisil AT cures athlete's foot with just 1 week's use. If you use Tenactin or Lotrimin AF, you'll be treating for 4 long weeks. But 1 week with Lamisil AT keeps you athlete's foot free for 3 months.
There's no better way to cure athlete's foot.
At Florida SEC, Vandy and the Gators. And earlier we saw Matt Walsh bang a three. He's wide open, but Anthony Roberson decides to do it himself. Having a good game, 12.7 boards, Florida by 11. John?
Thank you, Carl. Here it's Pittsburgh by 7. As these Pittsburgh seniors try to win for the first time here at the Joyce Center. Their last try, but the only thing they haven't done of significance within the conference. They're the winningest senior class. Brown, Page, and Torrey Morris in the history of the program. 97-26, the senior class record. That's a 79% winning percentage. Of course, the first ever Big East tournament title last year for Pittsburgh. They've been in the title game 3 years in a row. Quinn, a runner. He's had a dreadful night. Timmermans can't get it to go. Still loose. And out of bounds goes Demetrius, and a foul call.
Well, you talk about Pittsburgh and their success over the last several years, and I just find it hard to believe that they haven't been able to win one here. But then again, that just points up to how competitive Notre Dame has been.
Well, Notre Dame's had very good teams. They've been in the NCAA tournament each of the last 3 years. As a matter of fact, they're the only team in the Big East that has been in the NCAA tournament each of the last 3 years.
One of those things about Pittsburgh is that their success has been determined by the fact they have been able to win on the other guy's floor, not just protect their home court.
Good regular seasons, the good runs in the Big East tournament, including the one title, but I think the Sweet 16 ending each of the last 2 years has been a little hollow for Pittsburgh. Last year they were ranked in the top 10 in the country the entire season, and they hope to do better than the Sweet 16. Perhaps they will this year. Thomas, a long three, and all of a sudden it's a 4-point game with 3 minutes to go.
Look like kind of rewriting the script of the last time these two teams played, with a flurry of threes down the stretch by Notre Dame that Pittsburgh had to answer.
Krauser to Page, now Troutman with Demetrius, who's in there at crunch time, and Taft. Along from the corner, Page, a three.
3-point goal by number one, Julius Page.
16 points for Page. Tied for team high honors with Krauser. Thomas leads all scorers with 21. Jordan Cornette trying to answer the three. It's long. And on the floor to Krauser with 2:10 to go.
And this is where you have to make decisions as to who handles the ball, who takes the shots. You know, Chris Thomas has to be involved in that play, not Jordan Cornette, who's not accustomed in crunch time to shooting those three-pointers.
We talked about Pittsburgh's foul difficulties. Long way to go to start fouling on purpose, but against a team like Pittsburgh, you might start that earlier than you would against others because they're not a good free-throw shooting team.
Yeah, I still think, though, Notre Dame feels, because of their capability of shooting a three, that they still have a chance playing defense like that.
Thomas all alone. Timmermans, he's fouled by Troutman, did not make the shot. And Timmermans and Troutman are well acquainted.
Well, again, answering the challenge, you see again Chris Thomas running Julius Page off a series of picks. But stepping up to the challenge is Julius Page, right back at you.
Well, here's Timmermans, senior from the Netherlands. He did play 2 years of high school ball at the Blue Ridge School in Virginia. That one rattled around but stayed in. Brown back in, and Demetrius goes out. Brown was on the bench again for a few minutes with the four fouls. Timmermans had a career game against Syracuse here on January 17th. 16 points in their loss to the Orange. Also had 8 rebounds and 4 assists. That was his first double-figure game in 73 games for the Irish. Another big Monday on the way. It will involve Notre Dame again at 7 Eastern time. Brought to you by Bud Light. The Connecticut Huskies are here. And then at 9, it's Kansas and Oklahoma State. That's available on ESPN HD. Call your cable operator, DirecTV, or the Dish Network today. Big Monday presented by Bud Light on ESPN. Well, then a valiant effort by Notre Dame. Looked like it was going to be their night the way it started out. But Francis went out of the game. The game turned around completely. But Notre Dame, with this undermanned group, is hanging in.
Well, I think that they have an opportunity, if they're going to continue to play solid defense, not gamble so much, force Pittsburgh to shoot the ball outside and limit them to one and out. Push the ball up the floor as they did in the first part of this game and early in the first half. Get some open floor looks. They've got some guys. Quinn can now relax a little bit. They've got Chris Thomas' capability of hitting beyond three and make up this deficit in a hurry.
Pressure in the backcourt, and now the Fighting Irish retreat. A minute and a half to go. Pittsburgh leading for its 22nd win.
Again, playing defense without gambling.
And Cornette got his hand on the pass, and it's a steal as he deflected it to Jones. 1:15 to go. Pittsburgh by 5. Fans on their feet.
You see, this is why you don't foul so early and put it in the hands of the shooter on the free throw line. And many times you get lucky. You play that D, give yourself a chance.
Torian Jones. Timmermans, a crushing screen that sent Brown to the deck. Jones took advantage of it. It's a three-point game. One possession game with 58 seconds to go.
Now here's going to be the test Pittsburgh has to face. Again, mental toughness down the stretch.
Troutman fouled by Timmermans as they renew their relationship. We check the ESPN2 game track brought to you by Cisco Systems. Krauser along with Page pacing Pittsburgh. Injury to the back of Francis, a huge blow to the Irish. But Thomas helping to keep them in the game with 21.
And you speak of pacing, that's what Chris Thomas has been able to do. He's been very effective now, picking his spots. Now's the time for him, though, to take over. And the fact is, talk about mental toughness. Pittsburgh, like a lot of the highly ranked teams, they have an opportunity to self-destruct here. They have a lead. They've got to be able to execute down the stretch. We've seen so many teams get upset because they haven't been able to execute down the stretch.
The struggles for Troutman. They haven't been a good free throw shooting team in recent years, but as their coaches say, they tend to make them when they need them. And Troutman made that one.
And in doing so, he's made it a two-possession ball game.
With 45 seconds to go. Trying to run Thomas around a few screens. Quinn didn't get it. Cornette couldn't come up with a rebound. It comes down to Page, and he's fouled on a reach-in by Cornette, who's been active on the offensive glass but hasn't really been able to capitalize on all that hard work.
And this has been a nightmarish evening for Chris Quinn. You know, he's pressing now. That shot that he put up there, he literally threw that up there. That's not the Chris Quinn we've seen in the past, who has a good understanding offensively on how to get the ball to the basket and give himself a chance to score.
And he's 0 for 8 from the floor, his 3 points off the line. Meanwhile, Jordan Cornette has fouled out. He leaves with 5 points and 9 rebounds.
Number 15,
they generally play 7 or 8 men, and now they're without two of them, two of their starters, and France is out with a back injury, and Cornette fouling out for the fourth time this year. That's a team high. And here's Page, double bonus both ways now, each team at 10 team fouls for the half. And Page has it playing off. He's 69% from the line for the year.
Returning for the Panthers,
that was his first free throw tonight.
And you mentioned it, because historically, at least over the last couple of years, Pittsburgh has not been good from the line, even in crunch time. You know, Jamie Dixon isn't getting upset about it. A lot of coaches will wring their hands and put their faces in their hands and pull their hair out. He's just making moves now to make an adjustment to the fact that they may miss this thing. Got to get guys that are willing to play defense on the other end and continue to make stops.
One out of two for Page. 5-point lead for the Panthers. 34 seconds to go. And a timeout called. It's going to be a full timeout. And the flashback to last year, the classic here at the Joyce Center, under 40 seconds to go. Brandon Knight at 3 to tie the game at 64. But the Irish with a chance for the last shot. Capitalized. Taryn Francis off the feed from Chris Thomas. And Notre Dame prevailed by 2. They stormed the court after defeating 4th-ranked Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh ranked number 4 again this year for this meeting. And if you're Mike Bray, what do you tell your team with 34 and a half to go?
Well, the first thing you want to do is get the best available shot. Don't just settle for a 3. If you can make a quick 2, fine. And then we're going to try to make one stab at making a steal, and we got a foul. This has got to be a foul fest. As long as Notre Dame is behind, force Pittsburgh to win the game at the line.
Mike Bray, 44 years old, turned 45 next month, a graduate of George Washington University, an assistant to the legendary Morgan Wooten at DeMatha High School in the D.C. area for 5 years, then on to Duke for 8 years with Mike Krzyzewski. That's a pretty good duo to learn from, and Mike Bray learned his lessons very well. He has established himself as one of the best coaches in the country with really unprecedented success here at Notre Dame. 20 wins plus each of the last 3 years in the NCAA tournament each year. Road to the Pro Bowl comes your way next here on ESPN2.
And I think it helps that Mike Bray is one of the good guys in this game right now. Always upbeat, always optimistic when he talks about his players as well as his outlook on life. Just a pleasure to be around.
I would certainly second that. Mike Bray's one of those guys, if you don't like Mike Bray, there's something wrong with you. You got it. Question about the shot clock and actually the game clock too. They had 34.6 up there. As you can see, it's gone to 33.3. And they keep taking time off the clock without the ball being in play, might run out of time completely.
Every tenth of a second count.
I don't know how or when they ascertained that. I didn't see anybody looking at a monitor over there. They put the 34.6 back. That would make sense.
I think somebody's hand got a little itchy on the switch. Yeah,
I think what they might have told him is to put 33 or 34 on the shot clock, because they did reset the shot clock to 34, and perhaps the timer misunderstood and they did it to the game clock. Timmermans, line drive off the glass, rebounded by Krauser. They have to foul, and Timmermans up to that task.
Well, that was the best available shot, you'd think. Obviously, Timmermans got it, had a chance to look. Everyone was covered. He's wide open.
5 fouls now on Timmermans, and there's a little left on the bench for Mike Bray. I'll have to come back with Rick Cornette.
Returning for the Irish, number 11, Rick Cornette.
Pittsburgh's next 5 includes a couple of top 20 matchups with Connecticut and Syracuse. They just keep cruising right along. They can maintain this lead with 22 seconds to go. They'll be 22-1 overall and alone in first place in the Big East. at 8-1.
Well, right now they're playing obviously for supremacy. Certainly they get one of those buys in the Big East tournament.
Yeah, to win the Big East. Perhaps even playing down the road, it's a long way ahead, but it'd have to be a candidate for number one seed, certainly, in the NCAA tournament were it to start today.
But of course it does not. That's what I meant by supremacy.
Yeah. Thomas.
Oh, man.
Nice up and under.
That's
a timeout. Mike Bray came up off the bench. Will Bush thought he was going to call a timeout, so he blew the whistle. Mike Bray said, I didn't ask for a timeout. Will Bush said, you're right, so let's go.
That's what you get from Chris Thomas. Again, tremendously talented, but at that time, he showed that he can put a mean tackle on you as well, by accident, of course.
And Ty Willingham will come looking for Chris Thomas. Football coach, of course, here at Notre Dame.
Take a look at him right there. Chris Thomas trying to stop Carl Krause. Gets tangled up with him. Curious as to why that may not be an intentional foul.
Yeah, I would ask you the same question.
I mean, because he certainly wasn't playing the ball. And yes, there are times when you can block a guy making a cut on an inbound, but that was an outright takedown. And both of those guys making sure there are no hard feelings.
Krauser, 5 out of 7 from the line. 18 points in the ball game for Carl. 6-point game. They need threes now. Falls will take a long one. Rebound Troutman, and Pittsburgh is going to be in first place all by itself in the Big East. They'll go to 8-1, Connecticut 7-1. And Jamie Dixon, in his first year as head coach, making a strong case, we talk about looking ahead, for National Coach of the Year honors. Who's done a better job than this guy?
There is no doubt that he's got to be at the head of the list right now. Again, considering where the beat reporters and other media pundits picked them to finish in the Big East, the fact that a lot of people overlooked this team with the loss of Brandon Knight in the Orlando, Ontario Lett, and a bunch of other guys. The fact is that they've been able to keep this system in place. And the thing that makes Jamie's job and so superlative is the fact that he's adhering to the adage that if there's nothing wrong, don't mess with success. And
yep,
the system is here.
And the system's put in place by Ben Howland, for whom he was an assistant. The formula works. High percentage of field goals on offense, low percentage for your opponents. Great teamwork. This team has great chemistry and camaraderie. And another victory for Coach Dixon. The fourth-ranked Panthers defeat Notre Dame, coming from 15-2 down very early to win by 8. 66-58 the final. Coming up next, the road to the Pro Bowl. Now for Len Elmore and our entire ESPN2 crew, I'm Sean McDonough saying good night from Notre Dame. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. ESPN.